December 30, Monday, sixth day within the octave of the Nativity of the Lord. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. There was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then as a widow, until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord. There was also a prophetess, Anna. It may be surprising to find a woman prophet. The prophetic books of the Old Testament are named after their male author prophets. We are not familiar with women prophets, like Huldah. In the Old Testament, we know Miriam and Deborah, but we do not consider them as prophetess. At the presentation of the Lord, however, a prophetess enters the scene. Anna does not utter any prophecy about child Jesus like Simeon. She just thanks God for the child. She also speaks about him to her fellow Jews who, like her, await the redemption of Israel. As a prophetess, she evangelizes. In the story, we can easily identify that the child Jesus is the one who will bring redemption to Israel. After Anna, the focus returns to the Holy Family, with the child Jesus, Joseph, and Mary to return to Nazareth after having complied with the Mosaic law. Luke remarks that the child will grow up bodily, mentally, and spiritually. Soon, Jesus will be seen as a grown-up man, engaged in his prophetic ministry of preaching, healing, and forgiving. This is the redemption that Anna refers to in her own subtle prophecy with regard to the child.